In the summer of 1969, as the tribes gathered at Woodstock, and rumors of a thing called the My Lai Massacre began to drift over the scene, as American cultural values seemed to change overnight, the U.S. Army decided it was time to prove that their boys in uniform were not warmongers, but potential champions. The vehicle for this transformation would be the newly ordained Olympic sport of team handball.
I got a phone call one day from Department of the Army, and they said that I had been selected as one of four people to go try this new sport called team handball. And I was selected because I was an all-Army athlete in four different sports.
They sent down an order to the different armies to come and bring one athlete with them to Fort Bragg, North Carolina, I believe it was. And they said basketball players readily adapt. And it was all luck. There were six forts in the 5th Army, but the headquarters was at Fort Sam Houston. So the guy picked an athlete from Fort Sam Houston, and whatever reason I went.
I had just gotten out of basic, and I'd never heard of team handball. I had no idea. But, you know, when you're in the Army and they say, well, why don't you go here? Why don't you go there instead of, you know, staying in the Army and doing Army things? And I said, oh, yeah, okay.
The vision was an all-Army Olympic team, and the visionary was none other than four-star General William Westmoreland, often called the man who lost the Vietnam War, who ironically ended up being the guy who brought team handball to America. He thought his soldiers could play the game. Indeed, he thought they could medal in a sport so much like basketball. He arranged a lunch meeting at the Pentagon with the president of the United States Team Handball Federation, Dr. Peter Buning, the guy in charge of picking the Olympic qualifying team for 72. Almost instantly, the Army Champs program was born.
So I showed up and had no idea what it was about. Not a clue, except that I heard that it looked like water polo. Only basketball players could excel at it.
Very quickly, the best athletes in the military started reporting for training camps, soon to learn a game that none of them had ever even heard of before. The ones who took to the game were given TDY assignments, temporary duty, and transferred to the New York metropolitan area, where the program was headquartered. The ones who didn't were sent back to their bases, often with Vietnam their next arena.
I went to the commanding general of the fort, and I told him that I had an opportunity to try out to maybe play in this game. And he told me, he said, well, that's fine, and Danny, if you don't make that, then your next voyage is across the pond to Vietnam. So there was a significant incentive to do well.
Army Champs is the unlikely story of a team of soldiers primarily, with orders to learn a game that was as foreign to them as baseball is to a Frenchman. From September 1969 to September 1972, the film will chronicle the team's embarrassing defeats as they learned the game, their eventual victory over Canada to qualify for the games, then their miraculous victory in Munich over Spain, a top 10 power. They didn't win a medal, but they did shock the handball world. And along the way, they became each other's best friends. Brothers with arms. Learning how to play the game was no easy task. For a bunch of ex-college jocks who were used to winning, the first few trips to Europe to play top club and national teams proved to be almost laughable.
And then we went to Germany to play. Gummersbach was our first game, and they beat us. It was 33-3, I remember this, and we were getting laughed off the course.
These guys had come out, and they were small, and they were all out of shape, but they knew how to play, and, you know, we'd walk on the court and go, finally, we're going to win something, but we wouldn't. So, yeah, we got it handed to us. But we learned a lot, and every trip we got better and better and better, and we were becoming a lot more of a unit, too.
By the time they reached Elkhart, Indiana, however, in February of 1972 for the Pan American Championships, the tournament whose winner would go to Munich, the guys were beginning to feel like they knew how to play the game.
Because we were a group of really good athletes. And not only were we good athletes, but everybody had an athletic intellect. And we ended up beating Canada in a really, really good game. To become an Olympian in a sport like team handball that nobody knows anything about, and to know that that was your goal for 2 years, was really, really a good feeling of accomplishment. And I think all the guys felt the same way. We had a big party after that game. It was good stuff.
Overnight, our lives changed because all of a sudden, Department of Army treated us like, we're going to protect you guys, we're going to take care of you. We're going to make sure that you go to the finest installation to train, where you're going to have meals on a regular basis. You know, we're not going to be eating out of fast food joints anymore.
Qualifying for the Olympics was one thing. Competing against the best teams in the world with guys who had been playing the game all their lives was another. Training efforts were stepped up. Special coaches were brought in, and the team virtually lived in Europe.
Because you don't know any of the tricks that the Europeans use, you know, when to hold the shirt, how to pin your arm down, when to do this, how to put your foot out to impede someone, how to actually affect the accuracy of the shot without getting a foul.
We spent 2 weeks with Romania. They were the world champions. After that 2 weeks, I felt like we could play with anybody in the world. Maybe not beat them, but we could play on the same, you know, floor and be competitive.
The heart of Army Champs is the team's Olympic experience in Munich in September of 1972. From the inspiring grandeur of the opening ceremonies.
The corridor leading into the stadium seemed forever long. The national anthem was playing as we came into the facility. And yes, everyone was crying.
Through their heartbreaking opening round losses and 48 hours of terror when Palestinians took Israeli hostages during the so-called Munich massacre.
JR and Rico and I walked over, and there was a knoll that looked down on the guy with the machine gun on the second story guarding the door where the captives were being held. And I can't believe they let us get this close. We were on a knoll, and I mean, you see the guy's face. We couldn't have been 60, 70 yards away.
Put people together from different venues, see if they get along and exchange ideas and, you know, find some commonality. Well, that really blew that idea out of the water.
The film culminates with their unlikely victory over Spain in a consolation round game just a day after the hostages had been murdered. Their 22-20 victory still ranks as the most significant international game in American team handball history.
Very surprising, because we got ahead, we got up on them, and we were able to sustain it, which wasn't something that we necessarily were able to do very often, to sustain a lead. You could get a lead, but sometimes it's hard to keep it when you've got experienced players. Our first Olympic victory. And honestly, I felt like it was a gold medal afterwards. I walked off that court with just a tremendous feeling of accomplishment.
Westmoreland's dream didn't come true, but the Olympic creed could not have been better demonstrated. The essential thing is not to have conquered, but to have fought well. The Army Champs program and the team it created stands as a testament to military traditions, the athletic skills of the guys on the team, and most importantly, their trust in each other. That's why they are the true stars of the film. A cast of characters as close today as they were when they were riding European trains together almost 50 years ago. Army Champs will explore the bonds that are built through Olympic competition, perhaps to help define the true meaning of the phrase, team chemistry.
It was a tough time as far as the 70s. Being in the Army, everyone hated you. It was just ridiculous, really. We basically lived together for 3 and 4 years, day and night. And we would work out together. We'd go have beers together. So I think that really was a bonding. And then our kids know each other, so we've kind of all grown up together.
I think we shared something, kind of that, what we're talking about of the underdog and scrapping and getting beat and living in crowded quarters and riding on trains and all that kind of stuff, that we shared that together. The expression, they got your back, you know they're there. And to this day, this group of guys, I know if I was in trouble, they'd be there.
Army champs, a bunch of GIs trying to remind the world that they're the good guys. Brothers with arms. Ride on the peace train. Come on, the peace train. This peace train, holy rolling. Everyone jump up on the peace train. Come on, peace train. Yes, it's the peace train.